Here we are. Are we on now? Good. I've been looking forward to tonight, really, for a year and a month. We had tried to get this scheduled last Christmas season, and because of COVID, that didn't work out, so we thought we'd take a shot here in January, and we're glad that Wesley and Starla can be here tonight. I've been really looking forward to this. There's a lot more fresh, smiling faces here tonight than there were this morning, so... I preached to four people sitting out there this morning. I gave it to them, let me tell you. But we had recorded the service and able to put it out on for some who were able to listen and watch it. And it's always good to be in the house of the Lord. It's always good to be where God's Holy Spirit is, and He promises to be. Tonight we celebrate that. We thank you for the gift of chalk art and for this man and woman who you have given an ability to convey the truth of the gospel and the stories of scripture, how beautiful they are. I thank you tonight for your truth. We thank you for Jesus. We thank you for the great gift that he is to our world. May we cherish it. Even tonight, as we remember and celebrate it, God, I pray that we would cherish who you are. Thank you for this opportunity to be together. Thank you for Wesley and Starla, and pray that you would bless them and their family. And Lord, bless each person that's here that would be drawn to the heart of God during this time, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Would you welcome Wesley and Starla Wagner?
Thank you. it's been real nice living way up here in paradise over the atmosphere. But I can't stay long, gotta make my way. I'm leaving heaven today. You see, the world is dark and it needs a light. I'm gonna hang a star in the eastern sky, so everybody's gonna know where I touch down. I'm leaving heaven right now. I'm gonna walk around that broken earth, trading in these streets of gold. So if you ever wonder how much you're worth, you should know that you're the reason why I'm leaving heaven. Heaven. unto us is born, unto us is born. So wrap our injured flesh around you, breathe our air and walk our song, rob our sin and make us holy, perfect Son of God, perfect Son of God. Welcome to our
Jesus the Savior did come for to die for poor ordinary people like you and like I. I wonder as I wander out under the sky. When Mary birthed Jesus was in a with wise men and farmers and shepherds and all, but high from God's heaven a star's light did fall. The promise of ages he then did recall. If Jesus had won for anything, a star in the
Thank you. sisters too, how may we do for to preserve this day? Oh, this poor youngling for whom we sing, bye-bye, for
Okay, we'll start again. Now everyone can hear. Gifts for the King of Kings from Matthew 2, 1 through 12 is the drawing's reference. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 2, gives us a detailed and striking account of the events following the birth of Jesus in Bethlehem. It records the visit of the Magi, or otherwise known as wise men, to King Herod in his palace in Jerusalem. And then, from there on to Bethlehem, to the home of Jesus' mother and his mother. It must have occurred many months after the birth, which I've been telling the pastor the drawing would be dealing with the events following Christmas. Lost my spot. Okay, several things I'd like to highlight. King Herod, one of the figures you see in the drawing that's kind of muted out and grayed out, and I did that for a reason too. He recognized the Jewish tradition of the coming Messianic king. In fact, his palace that he set up in Jerusalem was really only second in extravagance to the temple itself. And he obviously, the Bible says that he asked his religious leaders to tell him more about this in detail, and he wanted to know about the Messianic king. But to him, he was a threat to his Roman post and his role over Jerusalem, so much so that one sad part about this story is he lied to the Magi about wanting to worship Jesus. Instead, he really wanted to just eliminate him. And we learn in the Bible then that it says he has all two-year-old boys in the town of Bethlehem and surrounding areas slaughtered. That is a hint to us about Jesus' age at this time, possibly a year old or more, because he did say 2 years and under. I show Herod in this illustration as a dark figure who's slightly out of focus because I wanted the message to emphasize Jesus as the one true and holy king. The story of Jesus is nothing short of miraculous from the beginning of the Bible, the creation, to the present, today, and what is coming in the future. The significance of the Magi's gifts, gold, symbol of royalty, and a gift commonly given to kings, frankincense, a sacred incense used in the temple worship, a testament to Jesus' divinity, myrrh, another perfume prized and revered as an anointing oil used in temple worship and in burial traditions, perhaps a reference to Jesus as the healer, and later his death and resurrection. The second half of the chapter covers Jesus' family and their escape to Egypt. I've not drawn that, but I guess that's another one. It's also possible that the gifts of the Magi gave to him would provide funding for Mary and Joseph to live and thrive in Egypt, because we don't know how long they lived down there. Could have been several years. Maybe up to even 12 years, because the Gospel of Luke is the only other gospel account we have referring to Jesus as a child with his consecration with Simeon and Anna, and then later referred to as a young teenager, where he amazed the religious leaders at the time in the temple at the age of 12. There's a big gap there between those events. Even Old Testament prophecy, I'd mentioned a couple here, not all, but a few. Isaiah 63 says, "The Gentiles shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising." Numbers 24:17, Balaam references a star will come out of Jacob. And Daniel as well. And I don't have that one here, but there's others. And certainly the Magi would have known these and would have been studying these, and this was part of the whole big thing for them to make this trip. Remember, the Magi traveled for over possibly 800 miles. That's a long time to spend on camelback. I got thinking about that. Because they did not want to miss the coming of the Savior of the world. So tonight, I encourage you to make this new year, 2022, a new commitment for yourself to live for Jesus in what you do and say, to bring honor and glory to our King of Kings. Thank you for having me. And I also wanted to say thank you to those that participated. Let me see if I can get it. Graham, for playing, and also his mom, which you guys all know real well. So thank you for that participation. One thing I will tell you in doing these drawings, digging into the scripture for details, as an artist looking for those little details, there's so much in there. We've read these stories over and over and over, and there's still little things to see and discover again. So I just encourage you to stay in the Word. A great thing to do for this year. Thank you.
Thank you, Wesley. I'm thinking about when I was a young boy in my church, Wesleyan Church in Dayton, Ohio, where I grew up. I don't know, every 2 years or so a chalk artist would come, and I was absolutely mesmerized to watch and see the story emerge off the page. And I felt that way tonight sitting right here. I thought, boy, I just hope he goes on for about 3 hours. I just drawn to it, and there's something about the creativity and coming off that page that's so special and conveys the story. And those three persons you portrayed as the wise men, just my mind is just, as you're drawing, thinking, who were they and what did they think and how they play a part of that story. Beautiful. And it's probably been maybe 25 years since I've been around a chalk artist again. In my first church, we had a chalk artist come, and I don't remember, unless it was you, I don't remember, it so long ago. But it was special, and it was precious, and I'm grateful tonight, the reminder of the wonder of the Magi as they came to worship Jesus from their hearts, and the hard hearts of Herod, and what a contrast for them, and what a contrast spiritually for those whose hearts are open and soft and tender compared to those whose hearts have been closed to the Lord and to the message of Jesus and the Christmas. And I'm so thrilled tonight to have another little piece of Christmas tonight. It could be anything from the scriptures, but to have an opportunity tonight. Wesley, I thank you for coming, and I'm grateful. And again, would you stand and express appreciation for Wesley and his work? I have questions for you, but I don't want to hold you up here all night. How'd you make the camels and Mary and all that come up there? What was that? How did you do that? Was it black light chalk? I see. It only shows up with certain light. Wow. Well, that was neat and creative. Well, we are grateful that you've come. And again, we thought it was going to be last year, but it was this year, and this is special. And I'm very grateful for that. We're going to receive an offering tonight, but we'll just have you, if you would like to give an offering toward Wesley and their ministry. There's a plate in the back, and you're welcome to leave an offering, and any cash offering that comes in for that, we want to give to them as an appreciation for being here tonight. Yes, Starla.
What's that?
Oh, yeah. On that table out there by the back is a book with many of the pictures, photos of Wesley's drawings, and I was just thumbing through them a little bit ago. Very neat. So if you want to stop, we'll have to get the lights on in the back, and if you want to stop and look at that, you kind of can see the variety of drawings and some of the ones that Wesley has done that are really neat. So you're welcome to do that. Thank you for being here tonight. Glenn Bailey, my friend, I haven't picked on you. Come up here, would you? Glenn Bailey was a pastor of the CMA church when I came here a long time ago, and we served together. I appreciate Glenn and his ministry and his friendship over time, and what a privilege tonight to have he and Darlene with us tonight. We're glad you're here. Glenn, would you just say a prayer for us tonight as we dismiss, and then you're welcome to look at the book. If you want to leave an offering for Wesley, we'll do that as well.
Thank you. Good to be here with you tonight. And let's go to the Lord in prayer. Gracious Heavenly Father, we rejoice in you that you're on the throne. There are so many things in the world going crazy, it seems. And yet we know you haven't lost control and that your promises are still true. That as you came as a baby 2,000 years ago, that you'll be coming again as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords and establish your kingdom of righteousness and peace forever. We look forward to that day. Bless each of us in whatever we face for the year ahead. May your blessings be upon us. May your vision for our lives be carried out. And may you bring revival in our area, we pray, that people will see the truth of Jesus Christ and come to know him. We thank you for this church and for the ministry it has. And we give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you. And also, I just want to say thank you to our tech team who's made this possible tonight. Appreciate you coming and setting up. And those that was broadcast, I don't know who's able to watch it on Facebook and YouTube, but look great. Appreciate it. Thanks so much for the time that you put into making this possible, guys. Appreciate it. Good night. God bless. Have a great week.